Hey guys, Vincent here, and this is Postscript. First of all, I want to apologize to you guys for not uploading videos in quite a while. A few years ago, my toe got crushed and the bone fragmented while helping a friend of mine move to another city. Turned out that it didn't heal so well and I had surgery last month and couldn't move around a lot, and making YouTube videos was not a very high priority during this time. But now I'm back on track and I want to introduce a new video format, Postscript. These are very short videos about topics that I couldn't cover in the original episodes, mostly because I didn't have access to a specific variant of a bayonet. So as my collection grows and changes, I will add these short videos as a kind of follow-up to the original episode. In this first Postscript video, I want to add a scabbard to my episode 9, the Hirschfanger bayonet 65 and 71. Like the Hirschfanger itself, it is an interesting note that they switched the traditional brass handle and the brass fittings on the scabbard with steel. This was, however, only done for the Jäger bayonets. The Fusilier bayonet M60, the Pioneer Fusheen Knife bayonet M65, and also the later infantry Seitengewehr M71 all had brass handles and brass fittings on the scabbard. So that's all for today. Thank you very, very much for watching. Please leave a like or dislike if you see it fit, and if you have any questions about Prussian or Imperial German weaponry, just ask me in the comments or send me an email. And this leaves me with nothing else to say, but I will see you guys in the next video.